Sorry, it's been a while. Welcome back, boils and ghouls, to another thrilling episode of your favorite hostess with the mostest, and a little bit extra, Sasha, the Princess of Darkness.
Well, kiddies, it's that time of year again, summer blockbuster season. The drive-ins are open.
As you leave the theater, folks, please be careful. Don't let this happen to your car. Be sure to remove the speaker before you leave. If you should accidentally pull a speaker loose, please turn it in at our snack bar or box office. Thank you.
The barbecue, she's ready.
And the kids, they're out to play.
Girls, come out to play. Warriors, come out to play. Warriors, come out to play.
There's a new Marvel Avengers joint.
You're all puppets. Tangled in strings. Strings. There are no strings on me.
Even a new Mad Max?
You're not the only one, Max.
Out here, everything hurts. You want to get through this? Do as I say. Now pick up what you can and run.
But wait, there's more. There's even a new Jurassic Park movie in the franchise. With Chris Pratt.
Okay, folks, she's a little shy, so give her a hand when she comes out.
Eyes on me. Good.
We have a new attraction. Think it'll scare the kids?
This will give the parents nightmares.
He just went and made a new dinosaur?
Probably not a good idea.
It's killing for sport.
You got 20,000 people with nowhere to go.
We're going after it with everything we got.
We're safe in here, right?
So, what should we watch? I mean, with all these great blockbusters coming out, even one starring the yummy Star-Lord himself.
It's not about control.
Stand down.
It's a relationship. Based on respect.
These animals are thinking, I gotta eat.
I gotta hunt.
You gotta be able to relate to at least one of those things.
However, yours cruelly would rather raid the overabundance of dinosaur-based mockbuster flicks in the old sludge pile. Sometimes I have to wonder how deep they dig in the rejected sequel pile for Jurassic Park to find these movies. I often wonder how long it'll take for them to dig up the one I wrote for Topps Comics back in the 90s.
Oh,
However, there's been dinosaur films in cinema forever, much longer than Jurassic Park. So we have oodles to go through and tons of movies to cover, even a few we may have to cover later on. We can watch 2013's The Dinosaur Experiment, directed by Dan Bishop, for Phase 4 Films and New Imagination.
In comparison to the rest of the Mountains of Jurassic Rejects, this one isn't half bad. Sure, it's lacking, but what low-budget film isn't? Here's the trailer.
There's a killing. This town called Fossil Ridge, Texas. Something weird about it.
How so?
They found the remains. It was killed by an animal, a large animal. Can't figure out what type.
The teeth marks indicate a very large predator-type creature.
By creature, you mean like a dog or a wolf?
Sure. The dog is about 10 feet tall.
It ain't Dr. Kane.
What about this doctor guy?
Dr. Kane? He's pretty reclusive. He doesn't like anybody on his property.
Will you say that again? Because I thought I heard you say raptor.
What's the plot? Well, Fossil Ridge, once thought to be a peaceful, quiet, desert, secluded cattle ranching town, now the breeding ground for prehistoric terrors from the past.
Engineered by a local mad scientist, Jack Gould, as Dr. Kane.
You're just a little girl. I used to hold you close. And sometimes you'd come and you'd crawl in my bed. And Beth, you remember when Mrs. Kane was mad at me? And she was yelling at me, throwing things at me. Oh, she went down so easy.
Under the guise of featherless emus. Which soon escape their confines thanks to a bunch of out-of-towners. Now banded with some locals, they all fight back against the cretaceous creatures.
What?
Tell them!
Somehow amid this mess is Lorenzo Lamas, best known from Falcon Crest and Renegades. Who's barely in it? I mean, his scenes feel like they're just tacked on just to be there. It's like he's slumming it in a low-budget movie, that the studio hopes to have some sort of draw from somebody who vaguely remembers him from the 90s. I highly doubt anybody who remembers this heartthrob is paying full admission to watch this movie, but it doesn't mean that it's bad. It's quite good and it's chock full of dinosaur rampages.
Probably a megalosaurus. Hmm. A large, well-advanced, carnivorous. Of the Carnosaura family. They're not sure about the color. Until now. Lived for about 70 million years. Middle Jurassic period. All blue must have been a teenager because they could grow up to be 30 feet.
My only real complaint is there's no formal explanation as to why, you know, Fossil Ridge resident mad scientist Dr. Kane created the dinosaurs to begin with. Granted, there's the featherless emu thing that's mentioned by some of the out-of-towners, but it just doesn't seem enough, and he's not given a real explanation. Is he in league with Dr. Jack Horner in engineering chicken dinosaurs? Maybe he was commissioned by good old Colonel Sanders to cook up some new fowl for their fryers. But I guess when you're a mad scientist, motives are incidental.
It's the millennium. Motives are incidental.
Millennium. Millennium, I like that. That's good. Millennium. Good kid.
If you've got an hour and a half to kill, definitely check it out. It's got a few noteworthy performances, even this really hot goth chick played by Alexandra Hulme. More than a few laughs, some intentional, some not. And then, of course, what you all came to see, rampaging dinosaurs doing their shit. This isn't a high-quality, big-budget production or anything of that nature. It's not taking home any Oscars anytime soon, okay?
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you to the Academy for this.
But it ultimately does what it sets out and intends to do. It's a great flick. If you've got an hour and a half to kill, grab a 30-pack, a couple of friends, be prepared to have a few laughs with this guilty pleasure of mine. I'd give it 3 beers out of a 6-pack, plus a shot of good old Fireball whiskey. This now from most online retailers between $10 and $15. Plenty well spent, so check it out. And that even includes shipping. Outside of that, ladies and gents, as always, cruelly yours, wishing you unpleasant screams. This is your hostess with the mostest, and a little bit extra, Sasha, the Princess of Darkness. Time to do my shot and find us some more movies to watch. Till next time, my lovelies. Kisses.
If you keep doing that, girl, you're gonna wear that little coochie out. I'm telling you, girl, if you let that little boy jump up and down in there.
Mm-mm, that's just tired. That's tired. That ain't cute. Tired.
Running around with that little badass boy.
Little Willie need to be getting something. I wonder where my little mechanic is, LA, because I've got to. Wait a minute.
Looks like a pit bull crossbred with a rhino. Hold on now, Mr. Dog. Mr. Dog, I'm just trying to go to the bathroom.
Ah!